I'd like to call the July 24th, 2012 regular board meeting to order at 7 o'clock. Please join me in the pledge allegiance to the flag.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Trustees Derenowski for roll call. Reese.
Here.
Duberstein.
Here.
Barrett.
Here.
Daly.
Here.
And Washington.
Here.
Mayor Linda Soto is in Chicago tonight on personal business, and I'm asking for a motion to appoint Trustee Gary Washington as chairperson.
So moved. Second.
Trustees Derenowski.
Aye.
Priest.
Aye.
Duberstein.
Aye.
Barrett.
Aye.
And Daly.
Aye.
Okay.
Okay, we're going to proceed.
Motion carried. I put him as his abstain. Oh,
aye.
Do you want to
aye.
Aye. Okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
You will establish the quorum. May I have a motion to approve the agenda?
So moved.
Second.
Discussion? None? Roll call.
Trustees Derenowski.
Aye.
Priest.
Aye.
Duberstein.
Aye.
Washington.
Aye.
Baird.
Aye.
Barrett. And Daly.
Aye.
Because you, it's not a conflict.
Right. I just want to make sure.
I do. This is the test.
Yeah, it's online. It'll be a test. Are there any public comments tonight? I don't see any cards. So. Thanks for coming, George. Kind of slim pickings for some reason.
Well, I'm not sure I would have a seat.
Yeah, get back in here early. May I have a motion to accept the omnibus vote?
So moved.
Second. Second. Roll call.
Trustees Derenowski.
Aye.
Priest.
Aye.
Duberstein.
Aye.
Washington.
Aye.
Barrett.
Aye.
And Daly.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Reports. Village engineer, Mr. Brewer.
Thank you very much. The Lake County Board recently passed 94 amendments to the Lake County Stormwater Management Ordinance. All the local municipalities have 90 days to adopt all the amendments. We're not going to review all of them here at this meeting, but in any event, they range from basic definition clarifications to actually some other ordinance revisions that do have some substance regarding infiltration requirements. They're going to be, Lake County SMC is going to be hosting some seminars which we'll be attending in order to kind of clarify what the intent of all these ordinances are, and we'll report back next month. As far as the motor fuel tax is concerned, we've got all the bonds and contracts in place from Peter Baker. We're going to be paving the following streets in Misty Hill, which is basically Heritage Trail and everything south of Heritage Trail, including Brittany Lane, Misty Hill Lane, Littleton Court, and Stillwater Court. That's about 55% of the streets in Misty Hill. And based on Trustee Derenowski's comments at the last meeting, we approached Peter Baker about honoring his contract for next year. They were agreeable to that, so as long as we can get approval from IDOT, we can hold the bid prices until and then pave again next spring. I don't have anything in writing from Peter Baker just yet, but they've agreed in principle at our pre-construction meeting, so thank you very much.
That's great.
Cool. As far as the Route 120 water main program is done, on the omnibus agenda, we approved the final pay requests 1, number 2, and number 3 for Berger Excavating. Those included a couple of change orders. The first change order was for $6,444, and that was basically some unforeseen site conditions, whether it's bad soils or some services that we had no way of locating that the contractor actually ran into. Those actually fit within the contingency that was allowed within the IEPA loan, so that's, those items will be covered by the loan. The second change order was for just under $12,000, and that was relating to everything associated with that underground storage tank that we had on the approved property. That particular amount, we are going to request from the IEPA that that get included. However, there are no guarantees with regard to that change order. As far as the school signs, we're on Route 120, worked with Jeff and we ordered the signs. They were about $5,000, so about $2,500 for the post, LED blinkers, solar panel, software, and everything. So those have been ordered, and we should get those in about 10 days.
Greg, are those signs programmable for just, you know, on for a certain time, times of the issues?
Correct, yeah. And then okay. We're going to get the schedule from the school so they're not flashing during the summer hours.
Right.
Okay. So, yes, we are.
What's the lead time for getting those signs in?
10 days.
10 days, okay. I'm sorry, I didn't hear this. There's a little talk about that, but are we going to be able to get them up and in and on the ground and up and running before Prairie View opens this year?
Yes. Yeah. Okay. Yes.
All right, good.
Sorry. Any other questions? Thank you. Attorney, Mr. Russell.
Thank you. We reviewed the intergovernmental agreement with CENTCOM that's included under business tonight. We also prepared the resolution for the all-natural hazards mitigation plan that's on our agenda for this evening, and responded to an inquiry from the business that was interested in this study itself in the village that would require a special use permit. It was a collateral collateral recovery company. We have not heard back from them since we discussed the special use process with them. If they come back, we'll make sure the board's aware of the process.
Collateral recovery?
They repossess.
Remember all the repo man?
Public Works Superintendent.
Yes, thank you, sir. Just an update. The beginning of June, I was out for 2 weeks. The boys were assigned to start our B-Box operational program, locating them, trying to open them, and painting in the fire hydrant. So we're ready to go for our ISO evaluation that's coming up this October. I'm happy to report that they have Deer Point subdivision and Misty Hill subdivisions completed. We have several B-boxes that are not operational at the moment. Once we have that list compiled, I will go out and see if we can get some more of them fixed. Probably about 50% at this point are not operational. They can't get the lids off. So we will come up with a case-by-case basis plan to see what is going to entail getting these things fixed. To replace them is usually about $2,000 a pop. So that is expenditure we're not going to do right now at this time. Not really necessary, again, case-by-case. Of interest, with all the heat, we've been using a lot of water. I've got the report from Manhard. Our average for May was about 225,000 gallons a day. June, we're up to 294,000. So it's quite a substantial amount. We really need to make sure that people follow the watering ordinance. The aquifers and the wells and everything, the levels are fine. Just precautionary, there's no need that we need to go through 8,837 gallons of water in a month. Just to keep grass growing, that's, you know, we really need to start playing with that on this. Make sure that people follow the restrictions.
Jeff,
we go back, what is a bee box? I mean, I know where it's that little thing in your yard.
It's referred to as a buffalo box. That is the main shut-off that comes from the village water main to the house. Typically, you would never touch this. The only reason we do go out there is if we have to turn off the water service. Obviously, you know, we have not had incredible amount of water turnoffs throughout the year, so my thought was, let's go out and exercise it, because there have been a few that we've had to actually go out and shut off, whether, you know, especially with all the foreclosures, you're trying to get these things open, you can't get them off, so it just becomes more of a time-consuming thing. My thought was, well, let's go look at all of them, compile a list, see what's good, see what's not good, and then we'll start addressing them, you know, on an as-needed basis, and somehow, you know, put a couple or 5 or 10 year plan to start replacing these things as necessary. Just, you know, it's there for a reason, it should operate, and these are things that most municipalities just will not, you don't go to them every day, you don't see it, there's no real need to be actually exercising these things. It's just one of those maintenance items that should be done, which we're doing now.
If there's a house that's in foreclosure and you want to turn the water off and the bee box doesn't work, what do you do then? Is there another way to do it?
No. Unfortunately, there's not. We've been fortunate where if I can't do it myself, I'll have a contractor come in. We have not had to dig any of them up. Sometimes you just have to cut it, and then you can get the dam to replace the head for probably $300-$400. You know, I mean, it's easy to do. The problem we're having now, especially with all this dry, we've had water services that are actually starting to break because it's dry so far down the ground. Water pipes are shifting. We've actually had 2 bee boxes that have just come apart. Those have had to be dug up and completely replaced.
For $2,000
a piece. Yeah. So that's, you know, it's a maintenance item, but we're trying to keep on top of it. You know, so everything functions as advertised.
Thank you.
That's all I have. Thanks.
Thank you. The only thing I'll add is, if anybody noticed or not, there was a new sign on the Public Works building.
Yeah, I put that up this afternoon. I forgot to mention that.
And that concludes my report. thank you. Building official, Mr. Craley.
Everybody has their monthly building report. Made a few dollars last month. And we got just about everybody in compliance. A couple people have to do a few things here. Most of the stuff on North Street, with the old land property, we got them to remove the chunks of concrete. They're now gone. It's regraded. Yeah, starting to look good. We're trying to get the tanks out of there. And now I'm attacking the house because the house has now become an eyesore and a half. So we're trying to work on that next. So we'll get those two, get that cleaned up. And then also, you got my letter that I sent to numerous residents that have looked back up to the conservancy on Total on the Ride. We found a couple that were over their property lines in the conservancy area. Stuff out of there and come into compliance. So I may got until August 1st. We'll go back and check and see who has and hasn't done it.
Have you gotten any phone calls on it?
Got a phone call from everybody that got one and explained what was going on. So only one person gave me a hard time, but I told them everybody who was. Okay. Your neighbor. So other than that, everybody else, as far as I'm back, I was only 2 of them already. Most of them were because they were just cutting the grass past the property line. So I just told them all, so you know, just stop cutting the grass, you're fine. And one person there was planted and taken it out and put in. Got some furniture in there, remodeled and planted as part of the backyard. So that's the problem.
Tell them the village appreciates your donation.
So that's, let's see, oh, we just heard this morning, Linda told me that a professional building will